Hello woodturners and makers, and a warm welcome back to my channel. Right, for this week we've got a bit more of this oddly shaped greenwood plum. So as you've seen, I've just drilled me a bit of a flat spot there so I can secure it a lot more, hopefully better on the lathe. So without further ado, let's get this on the lathe. Let's see what we can do with it. See you at the lathe. Okay, right, so all I've done with that is just measured the distance from both ends and then roughly got the middle of this side. So that can now go into there. Seems solid enough. Right, I'm going to be using the big FD 13.5mm bowl gold, and we'll start having a go with turning it. Got it to about 800 at the minute, so let's start chipping it away. Okay, right, so our shape's slowly coming there, but what I want to do is just mess about with this bottom end now, get that a lot more straighter. That's it. So now we'll just get that a bit more deeper on that and then start bringing it round a bit. Bit unsure about that bit there, so hopefully as I come round that more turn away. Right, we'll just carry on with this now, get this a bit more rounded. Just keep checking it, Check there. That's hitting that knot there, so we're getting there. There we go, just getting rid of that knot a bit. Just come check that a bit more around now, I think. Leave that flat there, but start just coming around a bit more for that. And then I'm just gonna mess about with that again. Okay, so right, so we're getting roughly there on the shape now, but what I want to do now to get rid of a torn grain and whatnot in it, I'm just going to do a bit of just a shear scrape, just a lump there to smoothen that up and clean that up, and then we'll be ready to whip it onto a chuck then. So I'll just clean that up a bit there now with a pointing tool, get rid of that little bit of a bump there, so then I can flip this round and concentrate, because when I rub it all down I can rub that down and in there at the same time, so I can do it all in one go. The bottom I'll do obviously when I turn that foot off. So I'll come back to you when we're on the chuck and ready for hollering the inside out on it. Speak to you in a minute. Okay then, welcome back. Right, the piece is now on the chuck, nice and secure. I've changed my tool rest to my S-shaped one, so that allows me then to keep nice and close to the work. So we'll start hollering this out now. Starts about 7.5 RPM on it. Okay, so right, I'm just going to run now because that's basically all I want to do. I want to leave a bit of thickness on this. I'm just going to run, get a rounded carbide cutter and just around a bit, get rid of any bits and bobs, and then we can have a look on that because there's a few cracks come, so we'll put a bit of glue in there and see how we go. Okay, so them are the cracks that are always on about, so we'll get some coffee and just shove them in. Just fill them up. Bit more. That's it. That's that. Soaking a bit. Well, that's doing that. Just get a bit more. Soak it out like so and give it a rub. Do that bit of punkiness as well. Rub some coffee in it. Just to strengthen it up a bit. Leave them. Now I'll put a bit in. that's that. Do a bit more on that. Stir it on the side. Sorry, don't need a lot. Rip it on there. I think that's all we need to do. Should have put gloves on. Well, we'll give that a few minutes, but a bit on the side, let's hit it with a bit of activator. I'm running out. Just to make sure that it has gone off. That's it. Okay, so that's all dry now and ready to go, so we'll just skim over that just to get rid of the filling that I've done. Right, I'll tell you the first bit. I'm going to start at 120 and go down to 240 using the drill just to go along, perhaps a bit in there, and then the edges I can do by hand, push up all of this. Well, you'll get a bit noisy. I'll show you the first bit and then we'll skip on. Okay then, so we'll get our sanding sealer on it now. What I've got to do first, before I put that on, bit of a wire brush, just get that a clean up. That's it. Try that bit of dust off. Now we can put our sanding sealer on. The same with this one, I'm going to go for the finishing oil on this one. Okay then, so, right, I've put the sanding sealer, that's the first coat of the finishing oil on it. So, let it dry, put another few more on it. And then what I've got to do is turn it round and take off the tenant at the bottom. Once I've done all that, I'll see you now on the signboard. We'll have a look at it. Till I've done all that, speak to you in a minute. Okay then, right, my live edge bowl is completed. It roughly stands at its highest point at 4 inches, and at its widest point measures about 5 inches. So there you are. Like I says, I'll take some pictures up at the end and show you the finished bit. Little problems I've got, bit of tear out there, couple of tail marks on the, just on the wings where I just couldn't get them out. So there you are. It's had 2 coats of the chestnut finishing oil at the moment, so we'll see how it goes. Put another couple of more on. So I hope you've enjoyed this one, and if you did, please give me a like, share it around, press that squidgy button. Till the next time, you take care now.